We all know that ANCA makes awesome machines. We also know that there's many ways to set things up and there's many things that can go wrong. At the moment, ANCA provides tooltip Tuesdays, social channels and YouTube videos. But we thought, what better way to impart more knowledge in our customers to create longer, better, faster grinding for them? Welcome to the ANCA Academy. I'm Tom Nathan. Today on the ANCA Academy, we're going to talk about all things collets and all things collet adapters, and specifically on the ANCA PCA, what it is and how to set it up effectively. Collets by their very nature and collet systems are one of the most accurate systems inside the grinding machine. And the more accurately we can set them up, the better we can have our grinding, the more productive and the faster we can go. Here I've got a group of PCA collet adapters from ANCA, and I've got one over here, which is an older claw unit system. Traditionally, with collet adapters, we would use a claw unit and a drawbar to close the collet inside the adapter. Now, this works very effectively for imparting the right amount of force on the collet, but the problem is with the springs in the drawbar, the claw unit itself, the pull stud, and also the collet adapter, there can be a buildup of errors. To overcome that, ANCA's created a PCA. And these have removed most of those errors with setting up collets. Inside here, we have a smaller collet pack and also some hydraulics. And what this does is it actually clamps the collet internally and we move all the errors from the downstream clamping systems. The good thing about this is that it can actually accommodate both radial and axial runout, of which most other collet adapters can't do it. So I'm going to go through today how you can set this up effectively and quickly for long-running batch automation grinding. Now, before we ever set up a collet adapter system, one of the main things we need to use to set it up are the tool blanks. And making sure that the tool blanks are true and straight is fundamentally the most important part of the system. Make sure you check the cleanliness and accuracy of the tools. Make sure it's chamfered at the insertion end. It's 1 micron in straightness and 0.5 micron in roundness. So I've pre-checked these already on a V-block and a dial indicator, and I know that this is round and straight. The second fundamental is always using a good collet. I have two Shawblen collets here. One's a nosed collet and one's a stubby nosed collet. I always check my collets before I do any setup to make sure there's any burrs or any swarf inside the collets. Anything inside here can change the clamping, and I want to make sure that they're all clean and inspected before I start. Using lint-free shop rags is the best way to do it, making sure the tapers and the internals are clear, and just using a visual inspection on the tool blanks as well, making sure they are straight, clear, and free of swarf. The next thing we need to know about is the collet adapter itself. As you can see, I've got three PCA collet adapters here. I have the W20, which is for smaller tools, the W25, which is for medium-sized tools, and the B3245. All of these collets use Shawblen UP collets. That UP stands for ultra precision. And if you have a look at the collet adapter here, it's got some features that will help us set it up accurately. The first thing we have here is we have a locking pin. So when the collet's inserted, we use the M3 Allen key to screw that down and lock it into place. The other fundamental difference with this collet adapter is that we have three adjustment pins, 120 degrees apart. And it's these pins that will help us set the axial runout in line with the axis. So when we're setting up the collet adapter, there's two things we want to set up accurately. One is the radial runout and one is the axial runout. The radial runout is how far the blank deviates from the axis of rotation. And when you turn the collet on the A-axis or the headstock, you'll see this as a high spot going down to a low spot. And the difference between the two is the total indicated runout. And what we want to do is make that zero so we don't have a high spot and we don't have a low spot. So in effect, we take out the radial runout. The second type of runout that we have is axial runout. And that's a pitching up of the tool along the axis. This can be seen as a clock screwing or conical runout. And what we want to do is we want to make sure that not only is the tool radially in the center of the axis, but axially in the center of the axis too. And this is where these pins come in to force. Using these three adjustment pins, we can actually adjust the axial runout to maintain that the blank is radially in the center of the A-axis and also axially in the center of the A-axis. And once again, I'll show you how to do that in just a minute on the machine. Something to be very careful with though is that with these adjustment pins, the pivot point or the fulcrum for the tool is the actual end of the collet. So when we screw one of these pins down, it actually makes the tool rise. So you need to be aware that when you screw the pin down, it will actually make the tool rise. So when we do the adjustment, we always look for the low spot. Similarly on this collet adapter, other things you need to be aware of is the cleanliness of the tapers before you start. Inside here, we have a taper that connects to the collet itself. And this needs to be, once again, cleaned with a lint-free shop rag, but I always run my finger along it and just feel for any burrs. The last tip before we start is with these adjustment screws again. It's much, much better to use a light touch rather than heavy force. Whenever I adjust any of these screws, you'll notice that I only use a third up to a half of a turn maximum. I never turn them tightly. It's better to creep up on the runout rather than try and get rid of it all in one go. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to install the collet adapter and the collet inside the machine. I'll set it up with a dial indicator. I prefer using a 1 micron increment dial indicator because I want to get this collet adapter and tool running within 1 micron axially and radially. And then I'll show you some tips and tricks on how to set it up quickly. So one of the key points about setting up this collet adapter system accurately is setting up the radial runout. Now in this system, I've already put in the collet adapter. I've put in a known good collet and a known good tool blank. What I have done is I've dialed the tool blank 5 millimeters from the front face of the collet, and using a hammer, I've actually knocked the collet adapter true to 2 microns with the clock situated 5 millimeters from the front face of the collet. Now that I've done that and I know that the radial runout of the collet is running true, I can move on to set the axial runout for the rest of the collet adapter system. The next thing we need to do is check the axial runout. Now, since I'm already on the high spot of the tool, I can just move the machine backwards in X-axis to the end of the tool and verify that I'm still in the center line of the tool. Here, I'm a couple of millimeters from the end of the tool, which is perfect for me. But once again, I'm just going to verify that I'm the high spot by moving backwards and forwards on the Y-axis. Once again, the highest spot is the center line of the axis. And yeah, I've verified that I was already on the center line of the axis. Once again, I'm going to zero it in Z, so I know that I'm definitely where I want to be. And then we can start the process of adjusting out the axial runout. Now, a really important step here is before you start anything is to back off the adjustment screws. You don't want any of the screws touching before you begin the setup process. Another important thing to remember is that on these collet adapters, each of the adjustment screws has a numbered punch. So this is screw number 1, screw number 3, and screw number 2. And that becomes really important later when you're trying to remember which screw to adjust. An additional point to remember is that with this adjustment, you want to find the low spot and adjust it up, not the high spot and adjust it down. For this, I'm using a 2 Newton meter torque screwdriver with a 3 millimeter adjustment bit on the end. Please remember, a light touch for this. You don't want to over-tighten these things. It doesn't help the system. So once again, I'm on the top of the tool, center line of the A-axis. I'll rotate the A-axis to see what kind of axial runout I have. And from here, I can see that I've got about 10 microns of runout. What I do is I rotate the adapter until I find the low spot. and I screw in the first adjustment pin until it lightly touches the collet. So for me, the lowest point is with screw number 3. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and slightly adjust that in until I just touch. And from there, every time I do any adjustment, I open and close the collet 3 times to reseat the collet on the taper and recheck my runout, my axial runout each time. It's really important to open and close the collet 3 times to make sure that the taper of the collet adapter and the taper of the collet reseat each time. Don't adjust and then readjust without opening the collet 3 times. So that screw is just touching. What I'll do now is I'll hold the tool in the center and I'll open and close the collet 3 times. And now I recheck my axial runout. This time the low spot's near screw number 2. So I'll adjust screw number 2 in just until it touches. If you find a low spot between 2 pins, adjust both those pins in 1/3 of a turn. I've done my adjustment on screw number 2, so I open my collet 3 times. And I recheck my axial runout. Each time I do this, I like to zero my Z axis. So my clock always comes back to a zero point. It makes it really easy for me to gauge the axial runout. The low spot's now, funnily enough, at pin number 1. So I'm going to adjust that until it's lightly touching 2, and then we'll open and close the collet 3 times and check that axial runout again. So now the low spot's moved back to pin number 3. I'm going to very, very lightly screw that in. And that was about 1/5 of a turn. I don't want to over-tighten these screws. They're just there to provide some level of assistance. I open and close the collet 3 times. And there you go. The axial runout at the end of the tool now, or the radial runout at the end of the tool now, is about 3 microns and under, and I'm happy with that. What I'm going to do now, just to double check that setup, is I'm going to put a different tool blank in, a different known good tool blank, and double check that nothing moves. Make sure you clean your blank, no burrs. And once again, the radial runout at the end of the tool is under 3 microns. So I'm really happy with that. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to move along the x-axis back to the first point of the tool, which was 5 millimeters from the collet front face, and just gauge the actual pitch of the tool. I'm expecting it to be under 1 micron. Well, Well, from what I read on the dial indicator, that was about 2 microns. So I'm pretty certain that when I check the radial runout at the collet again, it should be where it was before. And as suspected, it's 2 microns and under at the front face of the collet too. So now my setup's complete. I've put the collet adapter in, I've knocked true the radial runout, and I've now got the axial runout to under 3 microns. I've verified it with multiple tool blanks. So there you have it. This system is now set up for long running and accurate production grinding. So I hope that's been helpful and informative for you setting up your ANCA PCA adapters. Some of the key takeaways from today need to be: always check your surfaces that they're grit, swarf, and burr free. I like to check with a shop rag, clean everything up before I start, but always check with a light touch to make sure I can't feel any burrs or any swarf underneath there. Whenever you're inserting a new collet or into a collet adapter, make sure the tapers are clean too. Once again, clean them with a shop rag, run your finger over them, make sure that it's all okay. Before you ever start with any adapter, make sure you back off all the adjustment pins and also the locking screws. And with these adapters, a light touch is best. When I was adjusting it, I didn't use much force at all. The maximum amount I turned the adjustment pins once they had bottomed onto the collet was about a quarter of a turn maximum. It's better to go up and creep up on the adjustment rather than to try and over tighten and work backwards. If you follow some of these tips, not only will you be set up and grinding accurate tools, but your batches will be very, very stable. Well, if you've got any other ideas or tips for things you want us to talk about, please contact us through our social media or put a comment below. I'm Tom Nathan. I hope this has been helpful. Happy grinding.